What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I've been gone for quite some time, but today this is a brand new game. It's Fishing North Atlantic. It's one of the ones that I've been looking forward to for a long time. As you can tell, I have actually played a little bit of this without you guys, but today I'll be with y'all. So I'm gonna have to dock real quick. I needed to just get some more fuel. And we're going to go ahead and repair the hole just in case. And then we're going to go ahead and bring up our map here. We're at Angle's Head right now. So, holy crap. I didn't even realize we were all the way up there. And right there's where we're going to be going. I don't know if that swordfish is still good enough, but today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to circle us around this island over here. I have Angle's Head, and see if we find any more boats or points of interest. So we'll do that. Go over to this undiscovered port, kind of the same way, and then see if there's something down here that we could find. In this game, you have to find the boats, and right now I'm looking for a lobster boat, a very specific lobster boat. Once I find that, though, we're going to go ahead and continue with our swordfish right down here. Because I'm going to try to get us up to a little over $1 million. And right now we're sitting at $505,000. So swordfish is the most lucrative on here. So if we look at the finances, swordfish is $824 per pound. And tuna is $409 per pound. But that's also just the base. Different docks give you different prices. So we'll see it out. One thing that I love about this is we could actually fast travel around. So before we do that, I want to dock one more time and make sure that we have the upgrades radar. We don't have the highest radar, so I want the highest radar, so we don't have to be right on top of everything. And look at that, it's already paying off. We already found something. Oh yeah. Just like in Fishing Barents Sea, we have to get out of the little dock area first. Vipke Catherine, the bow's now and somewhere, I didn't see it. So I don't know if you guys caught that, guys, but like a little anchor will show up. Okay, doesn't look like there's anything else around here. Grand Manan Islands, so that's pretty cool. So from here, we're gonna go ahead and shoot down along this coast over here. Head. Okay, so we found two things right there. Breer Islands and a boat, so that's pretty cool. Digby Gut Lighthouse. Alright. Port of Digby is discovered. That's awesome. So guys, if you actually look down here, I have found 11 out of 39 of the locations and boats, and I only own one boat. So far I've only played 2 hours 38 minutes of this. So guys, I'm not that far along. Like you can see, I've only caught 91 total fish. So we'll get there. We'll get there eventually. So we've already been down along this coast, so but I haven't been in it. So actually, something cool about it is we can fast travel right there on little specific areas that we found. So that's pretty cool. We're already there. So what we'll do is we'll go up and back down this side. St. Mary's Bay discovered. That's pretty cool. Oh yeah, since I've already been in here, so we could just fast travel to Yarmouth. So we'll go ahead and fuel up here and go get some fishing down. Let's just make sure that we have all our gear. Oh, it's not even baited. So we're gonna go for some swordfish, and so we're gonna go ahead and buy that. Now I'm a little worried. Did I leave lines out there? And if I did, totally messed up. It does not look like I left any lines. So what we'll do is we'll go back out here and drop them and then continue on. And we'll go ahead and use that fast travel so we don't have to point up to a bunch of points. So from here, there are some little islands around on the maps. So like down here, I believe there should be like fast travel points down there too. I've already been through all this mostly, but I want to get all the way up here too. There's a couple boats and everything. Specific ports have specific boats. So like, oh, I don't even know what Yarmouth has, but I'm not even there anymore. So we'll just go ahead and go on down to our little fishing spot. And then we'll go ahead and set a line going that way. Toggle it at 4 knots. Did not work. Sorry. Still getting used to the interface here. Crew, prep the gear so we can toss this stuff out. This is going a little too long, or too slow. We'll go 10 knots. Pick up the speed. So I found with this also, fishing is almost the same as fishing Barents Sea. About 18 hours is the best, the most optimal time for you to haul your gear. And in this game, you do deplete the schools of fish. So you do have to be very careful in fishing, or overfishing, I should say. guys, on this boat, this is one of the first boats you get. Actually, it is the first boat you get. I have it upgraded with just the autopilot on it. If I wanted to, I could still do... Well, if I could get out... I could still go out here and go spear fishing if I wanted to. I just don't have it set up to do spear fishing or swordfish. And it's still all very basic out here. I have an upgraded motor. And other than that, it's a pretty basic boat. On the next episode, we'll be doing something I haven't seen anybody else do. Because I don't think they would have to skip any time. And we're going to go ahead and do some lobster fishing. That's what I'm going to grind out for today. And so the next episode you guys will see is when we are out lobster fishing on our new boat. Once I find the boat, of course. So what we'll do here, instead of wasting everybody's time, we'll go ahead and flip in a nice little circle. Line up right with our stuff. And we're going to go ahead and skip to about 14 hours. Still nothing on our, I almost said pots. I'm sorry, guys, on our deep lines. Nothing on our deep lines yet. So we're going to go ahead and skip another 2 hours. And it looks like they're all ready to go. So I'll go ahead and get the crew up. Manage crew. Deep haul line. Deep line haul. Sorry. I am so tired, kind of. So he's ready to go. So we're going to kick us back into gear. We're going to go with all six deep lines. Just look at this water, everybody. It's crazy. The thing I don't like about this game is you have to hold the button. Oh, I missed. That is embarrassing. I am sorry, everybody. I'm still trying to get used to this. Looks like we only got two on that one. So it does look like we are kind of overfishing this area. So from there, we're going to have to find a new spot. And that is something I'll be doing in between video recordings. So that way we don't overfish an area. And we can still make quite a bit of money. Perfect. The animations for deep line haul are pretty weird. It's still a little glitchy. I think this is it's on the 19th, so it's 3 days old. The game's only 3 days old. I missed. But I got a perfect on that one. So I know there's been a lot of bugs. I've already encountered quite a few bugs. It does look like your crewmates just suddenly disappeared. It actually happened to me when I booted this game back up. So the crewmate was gone, so I had to hire a new one, which I was lucky I was in port when that happened, so it wasn't that big of a deal. But look how nice this water is, everybody. They upgraded, or they redid everything for this game. The HUD is so much better. The graphics to me look amazing. Not so much the people graphics, but like everything else. Unless you see a tuna, then that is kind of a little weird. The tuna animation is not the greatest at all. He's got a floppy face and just doesn't look like a tuna. Oh, two perfects. Look at that. We're getting better, guys. We're getting better. So we got three more to go. That was a good haul. That was 1,500 pounds of swordfish. Our boat could only hold 8.8 or 8.8 800 pounds, I should say. We'll see what happens. Hey, look, hey, boat, Jim, get out of here. You're not welcome to fish on my grounds. Get out of here, Jim. This is my grounds. This is my swordfish grounds. Hello, it doesn't even look like he is looking for swordfish. Son of a... it looks like he's lobster fishing for some reason, which it's not lobster season. Yeah, that boat over there, it does, it's a lobster boat, but I think you could do more stuff off of it. It doesn't strictly have to be lobster. Just an okay. Only two fish. Jeez. 679 pounds. Yeah, it looks like he is fishing right on top of me. He's setting my booze down. Set me down. Come on, let's get another 1,000 pounds of fish. Let's do it. Perfect. Ooh, another perfect. So you're trying to nail him on top of the head, in the direct center. Bobby Boucher would have said, the medulla oblongata. So we got another close to 1,500 pounds of swordfish. So that is perfect. That is a good haul for us. We almost maxed out the boat, which is great. Oh yeah, look at this boat. See, I was thinking about it, getting this boat because I like the front. It reminded me of a northeastern lobster boat, just in front of it. The aggressive. Looks like he's all angry. It looked like a nice boat. I just didn't like the full covering of it. And I've seen these boats everywhere. The boat that I'm looking for, lobster, looks almost like that, just a little smaller. So we're gonna go ahead and haul back into port and see how much we're gonna get for these fish. We'll go to Yarmouth and see what they're gonna buy this for, the swordfish. Let's see. Oh, $8. No. We're gonna go ahead and go to another port, actually. So let's go to Dennis Port. Let's see if they have anything better than $8. $13. Okay, so that's a little better. So we're gonna go ahead and actually sell it, and that's gonna give us another $93,000. So that puts us close to $600,000, and I want to get us to about 1.3 million before we start lobster fishing. So guys, I think that is it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing what it is all about. Like I said, the next episode, we're going to go ahead and go lobster fishing. And we'll see how that goes. And then if you guys want to see more on this series when I'm not sick, you know, hit that thumbs up, hit the like button. Don't forget to comment if you want to see specific boats or specific fishing. I'm all for it. I love these games. And I will be here for the next 10 days. So I'll be trying to make a video every day if I feel up to it. Today was one of the better days. I felt a lot better compared to the last, I would say, 6 days. My voice might not sound like it's good, but it's a lot better. So, again, guys, I hope you enjoyed. If you're new to the video series, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and be sure to catch all of my new videos. I'll be trying to upload this today.